just like listening to the adjectives for every shot. Good. They've run out of words. Holy mackerel. Just like, what do you even say?
That's what he does. I mean, the guy's a magician. Six goals, four assists over the weekend. Tuareton finalist, no doubt. He's back on the show. Connor Shellenberger joins us. Connor, there he is. First of all, man, I just told you during the break, it's a joy watching you play. I mean, you're just a bad, bad man, and your team's terrific, and the season's been tremendous. And here we go, three ACC teams in a championship weekend. It just seemed kind of typical, right, between the combination of Virginia, Notre Dame, and Duke. I just had a funny feeling everybody's going to kind of get together for one last weekend.
Yeah, definitely. First off, thank you guys for having me on. It's awesome to be back on. And yeah, it definitely did feel like it was destined to happen with the way that, you know, that triangle was working out this year. So, you know, it's cool to have us all together in Philly and, you know, throw Penn State in there as well.
So when you have a single game record, 10 points, your first goal was very, very early. It was just a couple of seconds in. I want to know what your mindset was like during that. Like, as you score that one, can you feel when you just know you have it that day?
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, when you're able to get a goal that early in the game, I think it helps you get into that zone that, you know, all athletes talk about. And, you know, a lot of credit to Petey LaSala, our faceoff guy. He's been pretty dominant the last couple of weeks, and he won the first two out the front and, you know, made my job really easy.
You read my mind, because that's exactly where I was going to go, because we've talked to Coach about Petey, and obviously everybody knows about Petey, and he said, man, I don't even want to think about life without him here in Charlottesville. How have you guys developed that chemistry? Because there is a certain chemistry to that.
Yeah, yeah, I don't want to think about life without Petey next year either. You know, he's been so dominant for us, and you know, he's so clutch, and especially this time of year, he seems to thrive. But yeah, I think it's just a lot of reps during practice. We haven't always been the cleanest, I guess, and you know, a lot of it has been my fault. I'll take the blame. But you know, a lot of credit goes to Petey. He continues to trust me, and you know, he's such a threat with the ball on his stick that it forces teams to, you know, have to respect him and slide. So you know, it makes my job really easy, whether to shoot or, you know, hit one of our finishers, Cormier or Dixon down low.
Connor, when we had your coach on last week, he talked about the lead into Georgetown. He said, as far as being athletic and fast and physical and quick, you couldn't ask for a better matchup with Virginia and Georgetown. Given the fact you threw a 10 spot on there with six goals and four sets, do you like those kind of games? Because your team has so much offensive firepower. It would seem to me that, you know, it's like horses, man. Horses like to run. They want to run. It seems like that, with the way your team's built, man, that is right in your sweet spot.
Yeah, I think we definitely enjoy the challenge. And, you know, something Coach Tiffany's been preaching to us, you know, since we finished up the Georgetown game was, you know, it truly felt like we earned the Final Four this year. It wasn't a dominant win or anything like that. You know, we played arguably probably a top four team in the country. And, you know, we were battle tested, and you know, we felt like we really played 60 minutes of good lacrosse and earned that win. So, you know, I think it is a little refreshing whenever you play a team of that caliber, and know that you truly earned it.
We just had Belle Smith from Boston College on, and I was saying, if you're Mr. May, she has to be Mrs. May, because she just turns it into a different gear when it's postseason play, much like you do. What's different for you when it comes to this month and knowing what's on the line? How does your game shift a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, I think individually, you know, it's easier to lock in because, you know, I guess it's pressure, but it's also just, you know, realizing that any time you step on the field, it can be that last moment with your teammates, with your coaches, and, you know, everything that you've worked for since August is on the line. So, you know, there's really no looking to the next game. There's no thinking about the past. It's, you know, you just constantly have to be present, and kind of helps you get into that zone quicker.
You know, when Belle was on with us a half an hour ago, of course, it's BC and Syracuse this weekend, and I asked her, do you like the fact that, hey, when you start prepping this week for championship weekend, you're seeing tape of a team that you know extremely well? Of course, they know you as well. Same thing with you. I mean, you know, you guys get Notre Dame, and you've handled the Irish, quite frankly, in the regular season. Do you like the fact that, hey, you know what? Yeah, we're going to do our work. We're going to do the thing, worry about the details. but we're really comfortable knowing who we're going to play. Do you like? Would you rather be playing Notre Dame or Penn State? It's basically the question.
I mean, I think there definitely is a comfortability with playing Notre Dame. And, you know, I think a lot of the guys on our team feel really confident going into the game, just knowing, you know, kind of what to expect. And we have two games on film and, you know, we've had this process going for, you know, as long as our 5th years have been here. And we have a bunch of older guys who have played Notre Dame, you know, 4 or 5, 6 times at this point. So, yeah, I think there's definitely a comfortability with playing another ACC team for the third time. And, you know, we kind of know what to expect going into it.
Are you tired of looking at those Kavanaugh brothers? Because it seems like they've been there for 100 years.
I'm happy we don't have to deal with them. That's luckily, that's Coach Tiffany's worry for this week. I'm sure he's losing a little bit of sleep.
He has to deal with the game plan, not you. You go out there and play. For you personally, I know health has been something you've had to battle this season, but still, you've really only missed one game. You make it a priority, especially as a captain, to be on the field. What's it been like for you navigating, making sure you're practicing, but also spending a significant time, I'm sure, in the training room, being healthy enough to take the field?
Yeah, I have to start off and give a lot of credit to our athletic trainer, Rebecca Vozo. You know, we spent a lot of time together this year, probably too much time. We've talked about all the things, it seems like. So, you know, we've gotten really close, but I guess it's been a frustrating year, health-wise, just because there's been a lot of ups and downs and, you know, not feeling like you can practice as much as you want and have the chemistry with the offense that you need to go out there and perform on Saturday. But, you know, a lot of credit to Rebecca Vozo and then our offensive coordinator, Coach Curran, as well. They've been super patient with me and kind of helped me out through this whole process. So I think we're definitely trending in the right direction for these next 8 days.
We want to see you healthy because we enjoy watching you on the field. But you could have fooled us if you said the chemistry could even be better with this attack because you guys are so good, you and Xander Dixon and Peyton Cormier. How do you guys mesh? What's your relationship like off the field? Because I have a good feeling you probably spend a ton of time together.
Yes, we spend a lot of time together. It's, you know, there's never a dull moment with Xander and Peyton. I think a lot of what we do on the field definitely stems from the camaraderie that we have off the field. You know, a lot of trips to B-dubs and, you know, getting breakfast and all those little things that kind of help create the product that you see, you know, on Saturdays. But, you know, I just have to give them so much credit because, you know, everyone gives me a lot of the credit for, you know, making them look good. But those guys make my job really easy with how good they are off ball and, you know, even what they're able to do with the ball, you know. When I was banged up earlier this year, you're able to see how much they're able to do dodging. So, you know, those guys are complete players and, you know, make the rest of our jobs really easy.
Okay, Buffalo Wild Wings, bone in or boneless?
Well, I might get ripped for this, but boneless.
Same. I'm with you. Yes, I'm with you. See, listen, what? I'll take the heat with you. It's all good.
Oh, no, man. No, hold time out. Everything's just better with the bone.
He's right, though. You get a bigger bang for your buck.
Oh, come on with that.
Sorry.
I think my dad would agree with you wrong. With bone in.
Man, bone.
Sorry to put you on blast
always
like
with
that.
The bone. Anything with meat's better with the bone. I'm just telling you. By the way, we always have a good time with your coach, Lars Tiffany, because we always learn something. I'm just curious. He's always coming up with unbelievable inspirational ideas, whether it's a great book, whether it's something he read, something he, you know, whatever. You know, you've been down this road. Give me your best Lars Tiffany from this year of something he told you or you learned via one of his abstract concepts and so forth. Because I'm fascinated with Lars Tiffany. Give me your best one for the year.
Oh, man, there's a lot to choose from. I mean, I'll go with an idea that we've talked about a bunch as a team, and we have been reading the book Legacy about the All Blacks, the New Zealand rugby team, and Coach Tiffany. One of the things we talked about a lot is leaving the jersey better than you found it. And I think that really resonates with this team because of, you know, like I mentioned, the 4th and 5th years that we have, and you know, this 5th year class, the guys that came back are doing things that, you know, has never been done in UVA lacrosse, and they have the potential to win three championships, which I don't think has ever been done. So, you know, when I think about leaving the jersey better than and you found it. I definitely think about those group of guys that decided to come back, and you know, the culture and how they've changed it.
All right, before we let you go for real this time, we see the lower third here says that you're a Tuoroton finalist. What would it mean to you to win that award? If you just stop for a second and think, I know you're in the midst of trying to win a national championship, but to win the highest honor in lacrosse would mean what?
I mean, it would obviously be really special. You know, I think it's one of those things that you throw up on the wall when you're 7, 8 years old watching college lacrosse. But I think the beautiful thing about the Tuoroton and a lot of individual awards is, you know, it usually is decided by the team that wins it all. And that kind of takes the individual or selfish, you know, your pressure away from it and allows you just to focus on your teammates and, you know, just go and do all the right things during the game. And, you know, if you're the team standing on Monday with the championship trophy, you know, you have a high chance of winning that award. So I think that's one of the great things about it.
Well, Connor, as I said to you before, a real pleasure watching you play. And I know you've been on with us before, and you always hand yourself class personified. And, again, best of luck this week. It's going to be an ACC invitation, and we'll throw Penn State in there, too, for fun. But cannot wait to see Virginia, Notre Dame, and Duke in action this weekend, and we wish you the best.
Awesome. Yeah, thank you guys for having me on.
You got it.
Appreciate you, Connor.
Connor Shellenberger. I mean, a great player.
Great player and a boneless guy.